Hello friends, welcome to Let's Tute. Previously on Ecosystem, let's continue knowing about the ecosystem. Where do we get the energy to do different work? Yes, it is from the food that we eat. Food is a source of energy for all living organisms. And to obtain this energy, they depend on other organisms and plants. And that's how our ecosystem functions. Consider this. Grasshopper feeds or depends on the grass to obtain their food. This grasshopper is in turn eaten by the frog. The frog is eaten by the snake, and the snake is eaten by the eagle. Here, the grass is a producer. It obtains the energy from the sun to produce its own food. And all other organisms which feed on each other are the consumers. Thus, a series of organisms that eat one another, resulting in the flow of energy from one organism to the other, is called a food chain. Many such food chains exist in the ecosystem. One organism can be food for many. Let's understand this. Many worms feed on the same grass. The worms are eaten by the frogs and hen. If you carefully notice, the hen feeds on grains too. But this frog and hen are both eaten by the eagle. Here, if you see, multiple food chains are formed. And these interconnecting food chains are called food web. Few important things that we have to understand here are that sun is the driving force for all. Every food chain begins with a producer. Depending on the number of organisms involved in a food chain, the order of consumers too vary. Like, the food chain that we began with was the longest and had consumers starting from primary to secondary to tertiary and quaternary. But if you see the food chain with hen and eagle, it is the shortest, with only primary and secondary consumers. In this food web, if you consider the hen, it feeds on both grain and worm. That is, it obtains energy from the food of both plant and animal source, and hence is an omnivore. Observe eagle in our example. In all the food chains, it is a predator, meaning it only feeds on other organisms. It is not a food or prey for any other organism, right? Such organisms are called apex consumers or predators. They are always at the highest point in the food chain. But what happens to these apex consumers then? They ultimately die and are decomposed by the next set of biotic component, that is, decomposers. And the components are added back to the soil. Each type of ecosystem has such food chains and food webs functioning that help in the transfer of energy. Fascinating, isn't it? The next time you eat something, remember you too are being part of some food chain. Before we go, it's time for some quiz. Are you ready? Here we go. Can you name the producers and consumers in the right order in the given food chain? Write your answers in your notebook. Here is another question coming your way. Identify the apex consumers in the given food web. State whether true or false. Humans are omnivores. Hope you could answer the questions correctly. With this, we end our session. If you liked our session, please give us a thumbs up and stay tuned with us for more such informative sessions. See you next time. Until then, keep watching, keep learning, and subscribe to Let's Tute. Make it easy. Thank you.